Air Force doctrine describes mission command as a philosophy of leadership that empowers airmen to operate in uncertain, complex, and rapidly changing environments through trust, shared awareness, and understanding of commander's intent.
The name of the game today is speed, and speed wins in the modern fight. And so the reason why mission command is relevant is because you have to know, one, what's expected of you. We call that commander's intent. Two, you have to have shared understanding to know what you're expected to do when we call a gameplay or we change the game plan. And then three, you have to have mutual trust to be able to make decisions, to know that one, someone's gonna have your back, especially if you take on risk, and to be able to persevere when times get hard.
As a leader, you know, it's responsibility of that leader to give what I want that outcome or that desired outcome to be. And then you give space and some clear parameters for those individuals to operate within, and you let them go and be creative.
We need airmen to be competent at their job. We need you to be good at what you do. We also need you to be good at expeditionary skills. So being ready to do a multitude of different types of tasks. So you may be an intelligence airman who's really good at providing intelligence assessments, but you may also have to help set up a tent city or man a defensive fighting position or load weapons onto an aircraft. We also need airmen to be willing to take calculated risks, small risks, on behalf of their commanders.
If you're not building daily trust with your personnel, you will not be able to execute mission command under fire.
Let's look at a real-world example of mission command.
There are many great examples of mission command. One example at the squadron level is the 20th Special Operations Squadron, led by then Lieutenant Colonel Webb, in their response to the attacks on the World Trade Centers on September 11, 2001. The 20th Special Operations Squadron was training on the East Coast with their MH-53 helicopters when the attacks took place. In response to the attacks, Lieutenant Colonel Webb's squadron was ordered to go help Americans. That was their commander's intent. For the next 7 days, the 20th Special Operations Squadron did just that, helped Americans flying rescue missions over the World Trade Center site and coordinating emergency response with the Federal Emergency Management Agency. They did not need an air tasking order or other guidance from a senior leader. They simply needed to go help Americans.
You know, we cannot just have situations to where when they rehearse or practice at home, that it looks that radically different than what they're gonna experience when it's game day or in the combat environment. And so I think everything we're talking about in terms of exercises they can be a part of, both locally and large scale exercises, there's gonna be a big shift in the coming year where people, again, we're not just gonna talk about mission command, we're actually gonna do it and practice it. And I think that's what you're gonna see a shift on. And that will probably look a little bit different than what you see in terms of home base operations, but we're gonna have to balance it much more than where we are today, because right now our airmen aren't really practicing those kind of things until they get closer to the fight.
Now let's look at an example of how the force is training and educating airmen on mission command and how to effectively employ principles of mission command in daily operations. COVID shocked the world, but not enough to where basic training had to close down shop. We were one of the only military branches to continuously push personnel through. We were able to do that because the military training instructors and staff at Lackland were able to pivot and come up with ideas. For example, the trainees were required to be 6 feet apart, so the MTIs came up with a way to march them 6 feet apart. They were in columns of twos, 6 foot interval, and 6 foot distance. COVID really taught BMT how to be very flexible and how to better operate with acceptable, calculated risk. It's training, it's gonna be hard, but the force has to prepare as it looks forward into the theater of GPC and what could happen in future conflict. Airmen need to know what is at stake, and if they do not train with risk, how will they deal with situations far more dangerous and costly in the real world? This was a brief look at what mission command is, what it looks like in execution, and how we're training people to operate with this leadership philosophy in mind. Be sure to check out the other videos on agile combat employment and units of action.